Can you hear me? Clap one time. Just clap in the chat if y'all can hear me. Say something. Cause I ain't gonna lie, this is my first time doing this, y'all. Alright, appreciate the clap. We got the claps in the chat. Alright. Welcome to this is my first stream in a new crib, y'all. Welcome to the first stream in a new crib. Firstly, clap your hands for joining the first live in a new crib. You know what I'm saying? Y'all are my elite employees, okay? Y'all are part of the elite crew. Cause y'all, yeah, new crib, Tonio. I got a new crib. Yeah, we in this thing. It's a new crib, y'all. So excited for today. Sadly, we started late. But that was only due to the rain outside. It's messing with the internet just a little bit. But that's all right. Because we live now. Everything, we live. So, yeah, we live. I got the Sony hooked up, y'all. I need some better lighting in here. But like I said, it's raining outside. So, it's a little gloomy. I'm still trying to get all my ducks in a row. I have a setup. Yeah, I'm in the same state. I ain't moved states. Still in Maryland, my guy. But, yeah. This is my first time doing, like, just chatting and, like, sharing my screen. Because usually I be, you know, on the game. So, yeah. Shout out to me for, you know what I'm saying, doing something new. Y'all like the new setup? Y'all like this red? I prefer blue, but I ain't gonna lie. I thought this red was real nice. It was a nice touch. You know what I'm saying? It was like, you know, I like the red a little bit. So, we doing the red for right now. I like it, though. It's like, I don't know. I like the vibe. Tonio, we already know you like red. It's cool. It's cool. We know you like red. Like, my goodness. Now I'm about to switch it to blue. No, I'm just playing. But we're going to rock with this red for right now. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. I hope y'all had a fantastic day today. But welcome to the WNBA Draft live stream. As y'all can see, I'm going to be switching back and forth because I'm going to actually show the draft on screen. But y'all do not talk about me too bad because I'm still new, you know what I'm saying, to doing this. So don't talk about me too bad because I'm still new. So keep that in mind if you want to start talking smack. Yeah, but we about to get into it. So I was thinking, right? I got my little list, right, on my phone. I haven't figured out how to share my phone screen, but that's another day. So I got my list. Hold on, I'm gonna pull it up so I can tell y'all my list. And if you got your list, comment your number one pick in the comments. Who y'all think going number one? I feel like everybody know. I feel like everybody's on one accord with who's going number one. So I'm pretty sure it's a no-brainer. I feel like everybody, we on the same page as to who's going number one. But that's neither here nor there. Comment your number one pick down in the comments. A few of these people, right, that's on my list, I've actually never seen them play before. So while we waiting for the draft to start at 7:30, I was thinking we could go and look at some of their highlights, which I think is a fantastic idea, because like I said, I don't, the only, like, it's a couple people I've seen there, like, play in the tournament, but I didn't see their all season play. You know what I'm saying? Like, how they played during the whole season. So I'ma just say my top five. Okay, this is my top five. So at number one, I got Caitlin Clark. The center from Carolina. She gotta go number two. If she don't go number two, I see her going number three. That's Camilla. She actually number three on my list. Really, I want to put her at number two. Because on my list, I got Caitlin Clark, number one. I got Camilla Cardoso. That's South Carolina girl you used to talk about. I got her going number two. The Sparks need her. So I need the Sparks to do their big one and grab this girl while they got a chance. I'm just saying. All right, number three, I got Carmen Brink. Okay, I feel like she would have been higher if she went further along in the tournament. Because, like, basically 2 years back to back. No. Tonio, I'm not finna start. Listen. Okay, Tonio? Hold on, let me see how many picks y'all got in the draft so I won't be lying. Let me check. All right, so y'all don't even. Oh wait, no, y'all got the tough pick in the first round. Y'all not getting out of the top 10, people. I'm letting y'all know that. What y'all need though, I will say. What up, Flex? Y'all need a center, so y'all better hope all the centers don't be gone by number 12, cause y'all got a tough pick. And then y'all got like, oh wait, y'all got a pick in each round. So yeah, y'all gonna be straight. Y'all gonna have three picks. Y'all do, know what I'm saying? Y'all got her, so I feel like y'all will be all right. Y'all don't need, you know what I'm saying? Y'all don't need none of my picks. Not Angel Reese done started a live video. That's besides the point. But, yeah, y'all got three picks. Y'all got literally a pick in each round. And I must say, y'all ain't got, like, no top picks, Tonio. I'm sorry. Like, this is what it is. Y'all ain't got no picks. My thing is, L.A. Y'all, L.A. can do that big one, right? They got two top five picks. Okay? Two top, they got the number two pick and the number four pick. I need LA. Fours, we watching the WNBA draft, my boy. It start in like 10 minutes because it's 7:20. But right now we talking about who we got like going in the draft. We already said number one gonna be Caitlin Clark. Cause she, if Caitlin, I'm gonna say it like this. If Caitlin Clark don't go number one, I don't see nobody else going number one but Caitlin. You know what I'm saying? She had a phenomenal season this year. Did she get the win in the end? Of course not. Would it have sealed her deal if she did? Most definitely. I feel like it would have put her, like, how can I say this? It would have put her on top, but it would have just sealed the deal if she got the win. No, not Dwight Howard. not Dwight Howard. He talking about Ryan Howard. Hold on, I'm gonna show y'all. Hold on, let me show y'all one. He talking about this. Who Tonio talking about? Hold on. This is who my boy talking about right here. Hold on. This is who Tonio is talking about. This is her. She cold with it. I ain't gonna lie. She cold with it. She can do, she doing her doggone thing. But I do think she needs some more help. She definitely needs some more help, because they be, I will say that the Atlanta Dream been rebuilding for a couple years now. And I feel like if they would have got some higher picks in this draft, they could have did some damage. But they got the 12th pick. So, I don't see them. They need some more bigs. Matter of fact, I take that back. They need some more. They need another point guard. Or another two-man. Another two-man. Because, hold on. What was that record? Let me see. Hold on. Atlanta Dream. Oh, I didn't mean to say their roster. What was their record? All right. Dang. Okay. What was y'all record? I'm talking about for last. All right. Bear with me, guys. Hold on. Full team stats from last season. Oh, wow. They weren't that bad. All right. So, Atlanta wasn't a bad team. Y'all see my team? Down here. We're not going to talk about that. All right. We're going to leave it alone. What was y'all? Can I see y'all stats from last season, please? Oh, here we go. All right. So, Ryan was doing her doggone thing. She had 17 points. She was a leading scorer. Fly Jay still at LA. I mean Louisiana. She still at LSU. She ain't in the draft yet. She not in the draft. She got like two more years of college before she can get in the draft. Whole time. So she gonna be, I think, the draft class of 2026. If she don't stay another year. But yeah, no, Fly Jay is She not in this draft. Angel Reese in the draft. I need her to go number 6. If somebody get her before Washington pick, I'm be upset. And if Washington don't pick her, I'm be very mad. So for the women, you gotta do your whole 4 years of college for a whole time. Like, I'm not even gonna lie. If they let the WNBA have one and done, Michaela Fowale would have been in the draft. Juju Watkins would have been in the draft. Whole time Paige could have been in the draft this year, but she using her she doing another year. Dang, it's a ad. Come on now. Twitch out. Y'all ain't supposed to be doing me like that. Hold on. I'ma have to pause the ass. But I feel like they should let the WNBA have one and done, because this was the season. No cap in my rap. I'm not lying. All right, hold on. The ad almost over, y'all. All right, the ad over. They should have definitely let. This year they should have let the WNBA have what it does. Clang on cap. Juju definitely could have been one and done. Juju Watkins. I don't know if y'all seen her highlights. She was doing the doggone thing. Who else? Michaela Fuwala. She could have been in the draft. She was doing her doggone thing. She had a whole team, though. All of South Carolina team was doing their doggone thing. Yeah. But back to the Atlanta Dream. I just feel like, y'all just rebuild. I'ma just leave it at that. I don't want to see y'all 2023. I don't want to know if y'all won. Did y'all? Dang, hold on. Y'all actually didn't have no bad season. Y'all lost both of y'all preseason games, though. And y'all got put out the first round by Dallas. So, Ryan had 36 points. I mean, at least y'all made it. You know? So, y'all made it, you know? Y'all had a good run. For the most part, you know, so, yeah. But I feel like it's a couple, like I said, it's a couple people in the draft that I ain't see them, none. So, okay, hold on, I'm finna show you. Give me 1 second, let me pull it up. So it's only 12 teams. So it's like, I want to say it's like 6-6, I think. Let me not lie. Hold on. There you go. So, hold on. Some 12 teams, though, but I forgot who and what conference. Let me do my research. I just know my team's LA. LA been my favorite team since forever and ever. I'm now a Mystics fan because I stay in Maryland. And I'm a Seattle Storm fan because my favorite player on the Sparks decided she wanted to get traded to Seattle. So, those are my three teams. I do like Atlanta, though. Can't cap. I was finna go to one of their games last summer, but I ended up not going. So, let me pull up the conferences. Dang, how I... Child. Hold on. Technical difficulties. All right. So, here we go. Found it. All right. So, as you can see, the Atlanta Dream is in the Eastern Conference. So, we actually play y'all this season. If we get Angel Reese, I don't have no hope for y'all. That's besides the point. Okay, so yeah, it's just two conferences. It's 6-6. I ain't gonna lie. I need some more people to get on the train and get a WNBA team. Okay? Because we need more teams, man. Because, like, if we had more than 12 teams, we could do some damage. Damage most definitely could be done. But... See, you know, that's none of my business. If I had the money, oh boy, I have me a team right now. I got a couple people I have on my team. Shout out Gatorade. It's the red one. All right. About time to pull up the draft, y'all. Hold on. Let's go. Hold on, it's pulling up. 1 second.
Fans, Howard.
There we go.
Up Westbrook-House, ready for the 2024 WNBA Draft.
Let's go, y'all.
As you can see, the attendees here.
Let's go, let's go.
So many special people in their lives. The crowd is ready to go.
My name gonna pop up later. Because you know I'm a red shirt in the game.
Guess what?
If you ain't watched my YouTube video, go watch.
Let's go. As we welcome you to the WNBA Draft 2024, presented by State Farm.
The draft is on.
Gorgeous day in New York City, and the stars are out. This draft class, one of the most decorated in the history of this league. We know there has been an avalanche of momentum led by this young woman, Caitlin Clark. How about Cameron Brink on the orange carpet? You have Camila Cardoso, fresh off a national championship.
Hey, friends.
Angel Reese.
I'm in that draft class, y'all.
To the pros,
I'm telling you, man. I got to be number
the
five.
Next step in their lives. And the
I'm sure, you know, I they said, listen, they said I was going to five, but they said they were going to give it to them because they in New York. I ain't make it. So they gonna get somebody else, but it's okay. So you know what I'm saying?
As we welcome you to our set,
I ain't mad.
Ryan Rucco alongside
it's a part of the game.
Andrea Carter, the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo.
Cool.
We are so happy to be with you for what feels like not just a moment, but a movement in women's basketball. Coming off just an incredible Final Four. The league could not be in a more exciting place than it is.
Is my job excellent?
Y'all, let me know if it's women's basketball right now is at an all-time high. And this league has been poised and ready for at least the last two decades for this moment. We have the star power. We have the elite play on the floor. But it's still a bit of a hidden gem. Well, it's not going to be hidden much longer. And a lot of that is
oh, appreciate the follow. Thank you so much.
And Caitlin Clark. The way she has driven attendance, the way she has driven viewers to watch the games on television is going to elevate the W. NBA to the next level.
Okay, hold on. I didn't mute my mic until I talk. Hold
from
on.
Last season, and you came on and you said there's been a robust conversation around the Final Four. I don't know what's bigger than robust, but it got even bigger this season. It's robustier this year. And how do we play? How do we build off of last year? More talent, more eyes on the game, more bodies here at the draft to cheer and celebrate this draft class. It's gotten better and better. A movement is so right, Ryan. It's a truly special, special day.
You know, a lot of this, of course, has come with Caitlin and her greatness, her ability to rise to the moment over and over again. And talking with Sue Bird, I think she uses a great word to describe what it's like watching Caitlin. And she says, it's thrilling. We know she's great. We know she's captivated the country.
Who knows she knows? She knows she going number one. She's looking at her phone whole time. She knows she going number one.
I've seen in the women's game, and it starts with the distance with which she shoots the basketball. We've never seen a player shoot from that deep range with that kind of efficiency to spread the floor the way that she does, and as a result, can not only get to the rim, but can find open teammates. Simply said, never seen a player like this before.
You know, it's incredible. Her range makes you have to guard her from
how you doing, man? Welcome to the chat.
But Caitlin is also quick. She's welcome. Elusive. She has
thank
incredible
you for going
body
last.
Control. So you run out on her to try to prevent
so
her
far.
From knocking down that three, which she can do.
And I got a question for y'all. Whole time. Y'all know they was called Sabrina.
You were in constant
contradiction
with your
female Stephen Curry.
Caitlin Clark. She also
is
sit there like she
Caitlin
can't
Clark, the new female
Caitlin, proud of you on
Stephen Curry.
Proud of you for handling this. Truly, though, she's really special, and it's so tough to guard her. It's also so fascinating.
You in Indiana. I ain't gonna lie. You most definitely. I know it's a parade inside y'all city. So let's say Caitlin's name.
So,
Caitlin really got a target on her back. You know what I'm saying? She got a lot to prove. As soon as she gets drafted,
you can be her. And
she
that's
got stuff to prove. I'm real.
To Minnesota Lynx game.
We better see.
Maya Moore. Well, in Caitlin Clark's
what?
A great class, she
you think
see,
you think Caitlin Clark better than Sabrina? I can't. Hold on. Because I was watching Sabrina when she was at Oregon, and she still, you feel me, like it translated over
to
me.
That might happen on this stage later.
I don't know. We'll see. We'll have to see.
But I decided we should not bring her a puppy tonight. Caitlin has been so... competitive for most of her life.
I ain't gonna lie, Kaylin can.
Decided to learn how to ride a bike.
Kaylin can
she
throw the rock.
That her parents take the training wheel like off her
like
bike.
A
so
pro
she learned how to ride it that day too. She is that competitive. But her work ethic has made.
I ain't gonna lie, her workout. When I see her workout, that's why she shoot like that. She take 103 pointers, 100 free throws, and 100 mid range. Her mid range game go crazy, though. I ain't gonna lie. Her mid range game go wild. And she leaping with the moves, the cross. I can't lie, her ball is amazing.
Really cool shot. Her shooting is and we are about ready to get this draft started. To officially
let's go.
We said things
now. Who going number one? The commissioner of the WNBA. Who going number one?
The Engelbert.
Let's go. Who we got?
Good evening and welcome to the 2024. WNBA Draft presented by State Farm. It's an honor to be here as we celebrate the incredible talent that defines women's basketball.
All right, let's go.
The future stars of the WNBA. The past few years, the words momentum and moment have been used to encapsulate the massive attention around women's sports. But as we gather here tonight, it's clear that women's sports, and specifically the WNBA, are more than a moment. Arenas, long lines, and impassioned fans have defined this class of players here tonight. And that excitement has already translated to the phrase sold out, wait list, and record-breaking for the WNBA. The players being drafted here tonight are entering a league where the game is being played at an exceptional level. Our league has consistently delivered inspiration to fans worldwide.
My bad,
and as the longest tenured women's professional league in the U.S., we take it with great responsibility to continue to lift women's sports more broadly. And a shout out, thank you to our media and corporate partners, especially Disney, ESPN, who share our commitment to equity and empowerment. I've been reflecting a lot on how far we've come since I got here a few years ago. From my
appreciate the follow. Welcome to the family. Appreciate the follow. Welcome to the family. Appreciate it.
And now as we embark on this draft journey tonight, thank you to the fans here in New York City and around the world.
Appreciate the follow. Welcome to the family. Welcome in.
Appreciate the follow. Welcome in. How y'all doing? What's up, y'all? Thank you to those who have been welcome to the family. Welcome to all of you. All right, ladies, go on, say it's Kaylin. WNBA fans from today on. Appreciate it.
No problem. Thank you. Welcome in. Welcome to the draft, y'all. Oh, appreciate the follow. Welcome in. Oh my goodness, y'all. Welcome to the W. Welcome to the W. Let's go. Oh, I'm loud. My bad. Sorry, y'all. I got loud. My bad.
Indiana Fever, you are on the clock.
Indiana, let's go. I ain't gonna lie. It was surprising hearing Kayla no go number one. I don't see her not going number one.
The Indiana Fever, this is a team that reached the playoffs for more than a decade straight.
Oh, thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. Welcome to the family. Thank you. Welcome in.
They've averaged just 8 wins, but have had a treasure trove of first-round picks over the last couple of years.
Welcome to the family. How y'all doing? Welcome in.
Now in Indiana.
This is my first live on Jazz Chat, y'all. Welcome in. Oh, my goodness. Most definitely. Kayla Clark definitely going to the Fever. I don't see her not
picking the best player available.
I got six. What the world? How y'all doing? Welcome in. I got 62 people. I've never had that many people in my life. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Y'all, oh my goodness. This is 62 people here. Oh my goodness. Hold on. I got to show my mom in there. Hold on. I got 62 people here. Hold on. Hold on, y'all. I know Eddie been prepared. How y'all doing? Oh my goodness.
I know why the pick is taking.
Oh my goodness.
The one area where.
Oh y'all. Welcome in. My bad. Stop talking. Stop talking.
Well, Dre, you don't have to wait any
longer. Oh my goodness. I got 125. Wait a minute.
Here is the commissioner, Kathy.
Oh my goodness. Uh-oh, pick it, hold on.
In the 2024 WNBA Draft, the Indiana Fever select Caitlin Clark, University of...
We already knew that, though. The number two pick is what's going to surprise me. They got elite people going for number two. You got Camilla, Cameron, Angel. I don't see Angel going. The girls I see are going number five. Because Aaliyah in his gentle. But we knew Caitlin was going. We knew Caitlin. You feel me? Shout out Caitlin. I want to see her.
Hugging her family, her brothers.
Oh my goodness, y'all.
Brent, mother Ann.
Oh my goodness. I ain't never had this many people in here, y'all.
I don't know. Officially, the Indiana Fever.
I appreciate y'all for coming in.
Collegiate career as we
but
have ever.
I need Caitlin to.
Clark, now,
I need her to
start by saying,
take her game to the next level.
That we all knew this was coming,
I'm a little concerned.
Special is the way you describe Caitlin Clark. First player in Division I history, men's or women's, with 3,000 points and 1,000 assists. She makes the right reads. She finds her teammates. She plays with an attack mentality. And like I said earlier, you're in constant contact with yourself.
But see, Indiana got so many games lined up to be broadcast. That's what I'm saying. She got like what?
Shots from 25 feet or more throughout the
court. Hold on, I'm muted so y'all can hear it. She got like
in that time frame and some of the questions are
like less than 2 weeks for real, because the season started in May. She got like less than 2 weeks to really get WNBA ready. You feel what I'm saying? So my thing is she gonna be ready in time? Because she got a target on her back. A target. Like they come. Did y'all not hear what Diana Taurasi was saying? Like they coming. They coming for Caitlin. Caitlin, Angel, Camilla, all them got targets on them for real. Like they coming for them.
My friends over there. So. I think just enjoying the moment. Like you said, like I dreamed of this moment since I was in second grade, and it's taking a lot of hard work, a lot of ups and downs, but more than anything, just trying to soak it in.
I think one of the things we lose sometimes when we talk about
it
is
this
is taking a lot of really hard work.
Because I'm ready to see the FIBA. FIBA's been, they've been
in
a rebuild stage, especially when they got Erica Willa back.
I think the biggest
appreciate the follow. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
I went to Iowa with the goal of taking us to the Final Four. We did it twice. We went to two nationals.
She did have a target on her back senior year because they was expecting her to be on her revenge. So I ain't expect Raven Johnson. Hold on, let me do it again. I ain't expect Raven Johnson to go crazy like she did in the
learned to have and
tournament, the championship game. Raven Johnson showed up and showed out. She wasn't shooting like talk about, but she was keeping Caitlin under wraps.
You did earn this.
She was the only one holding Caitlin.
Indiana Fever, I know people are going crazy in Indiana for you.
I was saying like this: it's really gonna be a trio because you got Aaliyah, you got Erica Willa. I mean, yeah, Erica Willa and Aaliyah. So Caitlin, Erica, all them together, they gonna be shooting. Erica shoot like crazy, but her and Caitlin together, I see them doing damage. That's like for real.
Indianapolis. I know there's a lot of people. Aaliyah right here. I know there's a lot of people at Gainbridge tonight supporting us and the picks that we're gonna make.
My
so,
bad.
You know, I know
welcome everybody.
You gotta buy your tickets now. It'll be a hot ticket, but I think the biggest thing is.
If y'all live in Indiana and y'all trying to go to WNBA games, y'all tickets, you better get them tickets now. Because you try to get them tickets that day, no joke going to run you a smooth 50 to 100. Because it's going to be televised because Caitlin and I ain't lying. Did y'all not see how them tickets was going for the Iowa games this year? Crazy. Crazy. Crazy work. Who next? Oh my goodness, don't do that. Oh my God.
Thank you very much.
Caitlin, I got Camilla going next. 250 for the nosebleeds would really be crazy. It'd be 250 for the nosebleeds. I see Camilla going next. No cap.
Caitlin going to exchange some high fives and handshakes with some of her fans here in Brooklyn after she is the number one.
I had to tell my mama all y'all was in there. Appreciate the follow. Thank you so much. State Farm. He's there as well, hanging out. Jake from State Farm. Come on, don't be listening.
Well, moments ago when Caitlin Clark was selected number
one, I hope it's Camilla going up to in a big way. If it's not Camilla, it's going to be Cameron. Well, like I said, I don't think Angel going no higher than five. Only because she missed like the first part of the season, nobody knows why, which that her beast. I really was upset with a lot of people because they were talking bad about Angel. But, well, welcome. Thank you for the follow. Jake from State Farm at every draft. Don't count. He always at the draft. He always there. It's crazy.
It takes passion.
He always there. Heart. You don't think Angel going top 10? I ain't gonna lie. She can't not go top 10. I see Angel going number 6 to Washington. You all know why? Because she's from the DMV. Hold on, let me read this. She going to be number. No, she didn't. Paige didn't declare. She said she was going to stay her last year because, you know, she was out for a year with that injury. I see Angel going number 6 to Washington. Because she's from the DMV, they want her to be like the hometown hero type junk. And she gonna also help the Mystics sell tickets. So I see if she don't get picked up by nobody else, she getting picked up by Washington. I don't see them not picking her up. I don't know where Haley Van Lee went. I don't remember her committing to nobody else. I expected her to leave LSU only because of how the championship game went. And how bad they was talking about her. Real I big. Definitely expected
and that. Dream was
that.
More than women's basketball.
Okay, LaSalle State Farm for real?
It was possibility that I turned into reality.
I didn't know Caitlin was sponsored by State Farm.
But now it's my turn to inspire. That. If I can drop 40, you can drop 50. If we can drop 56,000 fans,
Caitlin,
you can drop 57.
I ain't gonna lie, I felt like Caitlin. I didn't need Caitlin to show out. I be usually playing the game. This is my first time doing like a just chatting type of live. So this is my first one. I'm gonna start doing these more regular because this is actually nice. But yeah, I'm usually playing games like Apex, 2K, man. I haven't started back playing Call of Duty yet. That's on my list, though. To play Call of Duty again. Of the Indiana Fever. I said that! But see, I'm also trying to go to the game. So I'm actually going to probably start live streaming the game. So, because I definitely need to see Caitlin in action. I don't see myself going to Indiana, though, to see it. Oh, no. Angel do not need to go to L.A. I mean, L.A. She do not need to be down there. She didn't need to be in L.A. or Washington. That's where I see her going. She do not need to go to L.A. She do not need to go down there. Angel Reese in Atlanta, I will not stand for. Because she definitely was in Iowa and now she going to Indiana. I feel like she's going to have a good time in Indiana, though. What's she going to Atlanta for? What's she going to do in Atlanta? Oh, Angel number one. Appreciate the follow. What is Angel going to do in Atlanta? No, she either going to LA or Washington. That's all they said. She's not going. She's not going nowhere. If they put Angel in Atlanta, I'm cutting. Listen, that's going to make me mad. She definitely not going to Minnesota. I won't stand for it. I appreciate that. Thank you so much. Do we want Thank you for the cheers. I appreciate that.
And Camila Cardoso, and then you she, give no. Chicago a chance to get
Rikia. What's she gonna do in Chicago? Listen.
They don't want Rikia Jackson in Chicago. Let me tell you something. They don't want to see her there and go against her for Angel Chicago. So do they take Rikia?
Needs to
and
be.
Then take a chance on getting one of two of the bigs. You kind of have to play.
Why is she going to Minnesota?
Teams might do as well.
What is she gonna do in Minnesota? The second pick of the draft. Minnesota. But I will say this: if she go to Minnesota. Oh Lord.
Selection for Los Angeles.
Oh, LA, please do your big one. Please. Please, Camila,
the second
please.
Second pick Come in on. The 2024 WNBA Draft.
Come on.
The Los Angeles Sparks select Cameron Brink.
Oh, okay. I'll take him. I'll take him. God, oh, what? Oh, my mama glasses. Oh, Lord.
All you can see, the
I needed them to pick Camila for number two.
The
all right, it's cool.
Two overall pick, who will get to
it's
stay
cool.
In California.
I mean, I knew she was going to LA, but I thought they were going to pick her number four.
National championship.
Oh, my. I got to stop
as a
head.
Freshman, she is the number two overall pick of this.
Oh, Cameron is a center.
And will head
Big
to
man.
The LA Sparks is a
she's 6'4".
Of this rebuild.
Hey, Cameron and Camila duo would be insane. But she's 6'4", and Camila like 6'7", ain't it? That's the doggone twin power.
Rebounding and rim protection, you can't get much better than Cameron Brink. She led the nation
she
this
just,
past
she's,
season.
She ain't gonna lie.
3.7 blocks per game.
She big and lanky.
The game as well.
So it's like
good in the WNBA.
They could
Brink
play off each other nicely
upside,
because
four,
of how
elite when it comes
one
to
how aggressive Camila is. Cause you saw how she was going with Angel Reese. Camila and Angel Reese were going back and forth.
The LA Sparks can use. They were 11th in rebounds per
game. Oh yeah, and then. She was what's called gossip or something. So I felt like she was gonna end up in LA. If she didn't end up in LA, I didn't see her going past number three.
Well, you are emotional. You are emotional.
She tall as a mug.
So much into
she's
6'4".
Man,
I'm sorry.
Appreciate the follow. Welcome to the family. I don't think he's the owner. I think he bought into the team though.
It's just such a
appreciate the follow. I think he bought into the sky somehow.
What a great job we've done.
But
so proud
Cameron.
Of
oh, I appreciate the follow, y'all. Thank you. Welcome in.
And I'm just very thankful.
You've been training since you were in high school with the best trainer in the WNBA, Susan Borchardt.
What?
You have been building to this moment.
236 people here. I appreciate y'all for being here. Appreciate you for the sub. Appreciate the sub. I ain't never had that many people in my life before. I appreciate y'all for being here rocking with me.
You've listed all the amazing people in my life.
Diamond the Shields is in the free agency. What?
Mom and Dad,
when she did that,
either.
See, I gotta start paying attention to the little thing. Cause why Diamond and Shields done went to the
village.
The for what?
And my friends, Jenna Brown.
Appreciate the follow.
In the crowd, so I'm just so blessed to have the people I have.
I do see Camila going number three now. I want her to go number two though, and I want them to pick up Cameron number four.
With the game, how are you right now? What will that look like?
Oh my goodness!
Put on that jersey for the LA Sparks.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Franchise trying to get back.
I'm disappointed.
I think I fall in love with the game even more. Just
my bad for the
laugh. With these girls, I feel like.
Appreciate you for the cheers. Thank you.
Hard,
appreciate it.
I'm just so looking forward.
I'm really
to
upset, y'all.
Ready to get started.
I wanted Camila to go number two.
You.
She deserved it. Did y'all not see Camila in the tournament? Why is she not number two?
The third selection will be made by Chicago.
They bet not pick her.
Phoenix.
Please don't let Angel go to Minnesota. Let her come to Washington. Please.
Slides into the third
please,
spot
love.
With a brand new
please
head coach, Teresa Weatherspoon.
Okay.
A legend in this league. You can see her career accolades both in college.
I feel like Camila deserved to be number two. I don't know how she didn't go number two. She deserved it.
The WNBA, it
and they could have just picked up Cameron number four.
For
LA, y'all not doing y'all big one like I said, but it's okay. It's okay. Okay, I'm upset. And then Diamond the Shields just threw me off. Cause why are you in the free agency? For what? But it's okay. Please listen. If y'all, if they, I'm looking at you. Please, let Angel come to the Mystics. When I tell you, it will be so great, because you got to think about it. This her home. This what she got her bread and butter from.
Teresa Weatherspoon has already accomplished.
Come on, man.
Now to this next challenge, Rebecca.
This is what made Angel who Angel is. Tony, are you getting this chat? Talking about Angel to Atlanta one more time. She's not going. Atlanta got the 12th pick. Angel gonna be gone. No. Angel is not going past number six. Okay, she's not going to Atlanta. I'm so sorry to tell y'all. She's not going to Atlanta. She's not. Okay.
I would run through a wall for Teresa. There's not anything she could tell me to do, but I'd be like, probably not.
Because I think about it. Her doing them workout videos. Her doing them workout videos up to a drop spot. No cap. Because everybody was saying, Angel can't shoot. Angel don't really play defense. Angel did. And what this next rookie is going to get. Did y'all not see her shooting the middies?
Next rookie back to the podium. Here's Kathy Engelbert with the number three overall selection.
Do your big one. Don't let me Angel. Don't let me Angel.
With the third pick in the 2024 WNBA draft, the Chicago Sky select Camilla Carter.
All right. There we go. Good job. Yeah. We still got Angel. Yes. Don't nobody care about Ben Simmons. So grateful. Thank you, Camille. I'm crying. I feel like a proud mother. My goodness. Let's go, Camilla. She about to do her big one for the Sky. I ain't gonna lie.
Number three overall.
If Candace was still with the Sky, would have been a nice duo.
To the
LA, you didn't do your big one because I wanted Camilla to go to LA. Appreciate the follow. Thank you. Welcome in.
What a journey for Camilla. ACC,
no, they do not know where they're going beforehand. I wish they did, but they don't.
She is efficient. She's dominant. She can finish on the inside. She can block shots on the defense.
Appreciate the follow. Thank you.
Beautiful fit for Camilla. I'm excited for her. It certainly fits the need for Chicago. This is a team that lacks size. No player on their roster bigger than 6'3 or 6'4.
Y'all, I got a lot of people
right
here.
Now to run and push who finna
drive Haley? Haley said she gonna say another
every single time down the floor.
That's Haley. I ain't gonna lie. Haley is
a good rim runner. Perfect.
Technically, Haley should have entered the draft last draft.
Understandably excited about the addition.
Man, dang it. I needed them to get Camilla to LA. The twins would be crazy. Cameron and Camilla together would be crazy.
How special is it that she is here with your mother from Brazil to celebrate you tonight?
Get it together.
That she's here. She's one of my biggest inspirations. She's the reason why
I'm so proud of you, Camilla.
Because she's inspired me to play basketball.
I'm so proud of you.
So thankful that she's able to be here.
Now we still got Rakia Jackson in this picture.
You had to maybe more than any other player here at the draft. You had to leave home from Brazil at 15 years old. You didn't
Angel
see the language.
Is not.
And
I
here
want
you
to get
are.
Close
Why
to
did
y'all.
You believe in yourself so much
Angel's
at such a young age?
To Atlanta.
I had a goal to be here tonight and give my family a better life.
She's not going to Atlanta.
I'm just so thankful that.
She's not going to Atlanta. I don't see Angel in Dallas either.
I don't see Angel in LA
or the Mystics.
What do you know about Chicago?
Chicago,
they
LA, or Washington?
Embrace you there.
I really hope Washington.
I'm just so excited to get there.
Why is she favored by Atlanta?
Congratulations.
For what? She's not going that low in the draft. Atlanta only got three picks. They got the 12th pick in the first round. What's the other pick? Hold on, what's the other pick that they got? They got the 20th pick in the second round.
Sky,
and the 32nd pick in the third round. Angel's not going 12. She got to go to LA or Washington. I won't allow her to go anywhere else.
Who will they add to Cameron Brink? And how about LA and where
Listen.
They are right now in this moment as a franchise?
They lost Necker.
Rebuilding.
We lost Necker in a free agency. I need LA to do their big one. and give me somebody to help Cameron.
The LA Sparks have not been in the playoffs for the last 3 years.
I need LA in the playoffs this year.
And it is much needed. They just hired a new GM in Reggie Peabody. They have a new team.
LA need. I need it. Because y'all already got rid of Tia Cooper. And Tia was actually doing it all.
With the Las Vegas Aces.
Angel, we are hoping that team is investing in the future. Is she not going to get picked up right here for number four? She getting picked up for number six. I don't want to hear Angel going nowhere.
And that is in the WNBA playoffs.
Well, we certainly would expect that sometime in the near future. And how about or she's going to them and join Cameron Brink, the number four overall pick, and back to the podium we go with Commissioner.
All right, let's go. Come on. Come on. Come on.
With the fourth pick in the 2024 WNBA draft,
do your big one.
The Los Angeles Sparks select Rekia Jackson.
Okay, okay. I'm not mad. I'm not mad. I'm not mad at this pick. I'm not mad.
Well,
I'm not mad. And Rekia, I'm not mad.
The number four overall.
I'm not. Listen.
All right.
Y'all see Angel still here. Washington. If she don't get picked up next, Washington, do your big one again. Okay? Do not let Angel go anywhere but Washington. Hear me. We hear.
At four, a foundation for the Sparks to build upon, and one that has to be very exciting.
Listen. Angel not gonna flop. I don't see Angel flopping. I don't see Angel flopping. I'm definitely gonna be pissed you on Minnesota. Minnesota's not a bad team. Cause you know she's a small Augusta fan, and you know Simone played for them, Minnesota. But
smaller players and has terrific footwork.
I see what you can think about this. Washington still got Shakira, what's that girl name? She from Ole Miss. She got drafted in 2022. I think Shakira Artist, something like that. Her Angel could do some damage. I'm not mad at them picking Rekia. I'm not mad.
She's a natural scorer and a great choice for LA.
In LA, yeah, they're excited. Little
Cameron,
party, they're ready to go.
Y'all got Cameron
is the and Rekia of the LA Sparks. All
right,
and
now,
she is with Holly.
Well,
no,
you know, as we look at your
Angel can't go there. Angel's not gonna be going that low in the draft. They're not gonna let her go there.
Make an impact this season in the WNBA.
You got this. Not only is she good for marketing, Angel can really play for real. She's an amazing defender. You know what I'm saying? And now she's working on her shooting, which gonna make her, you know what I'm saying, a double threat. I don't know if Angel's going to Connecticut either. I'm telling you, I need her to go to Washington. I need her to be the hometown hero. I need her to be like, oh, I'm staying at home. Ooh, you know what I'm saying?
How has your family helped you get into this moment?
My family.
Now, Rekia do look nice. That's nice, too, girl. You did your thing. Number four pick. Welcome to LA. Welcome to the winning team, baby. And LA, I give y'all this because I said I need y'all to do y'all big ones.
Really just made me
y'all did.
Today.
So LA,
to the LA Sparks fans, you are the first draftee that I think did a wardrobe change from the orange carpet to here. They're getting a little sat, a little sizzle, a little bedazzle. Tell us,
Cameron,
the fans are gonna be.
Don't you get out here and be playing like you don't know how to play?
I just fall in love with my personality.
Okay.
You know, I just like the.
All right, Rekia, don't get up after playing shot. I need you to do your doggone thing. We got to get to the playoffs, okay?
And I'm just ready to win.
Come on.
The greats of the Vols,
come on.
Lady Vols, Candace Parker played there. You are now stepping into that kind of similar dynasty. What does that mean to you as a Lady Vol?
It means a
Rekia,
lot.
Let's go.
You know, Candace was a Tennessee, was at
I mean,
LA.
Angel.
And being at
okay, so let me see who all left from
so,
my thing. Hold
you know,
on.
I just think it's pretty cool.
All right, very cool. Congratulations. The Sparks are so lucky.
Thank you.
Well, Rekia Jackson, Cameron Brink, both members of the Sparks, four picks down, many more to come.
All right.
Number five.
So from my list, they still left.
A lot of talent left. A lot of
man. No.
Enjoying the fifth pick coming up next.
All right. I see Aaliyah Edwards going next. Is it going to be Angel or Aaliyah? So watch, they're going to get Angel or they're going to get Aaliyah. Dang, you ain't gotta say she's gonna look ugly in the Dallas jersey now, but hey, I can't say. that I'm not gonna disagree. I need. Okay. I'm nervous. Okay, I will say this. When they had Candace Parker, they was rebuilding like a mug. They was rebuilding like a mug when they had Candace. Appreciate the follow. So, with that being said, I don't know how they are right now.
We're done.
What about this? I don't know how they are right now. So, I ain't keep up with the sky. Appreciate the follow. Welcome to the family. Welcome in. Appreciate the follow. So, Aaliyah
bet on the young guy.
On Angels finna go next.
Well, the vets have been there before. My man.
No.
So, Ben Ray Cousins, right?
How many Atlanta Dream fans up in this chat right now?
I really think experience.
I'm finna tell y'all right now.
Playoffs.
I'm so sorry.
You're right.
Y'all could get. Hold on. Let me see who y'all could get.
How about a Barker square, Mr. Van Pelt? Absolutely.
Y'all can get Days of Fair.
For the second year,
y'all can get Days of Fair.
Has been ranked by JD Power.
I get y'all Days of Fair. That's all I'm giving y'all. SUVs. Y'all can't have Angel. I'm sorry.
In other words, it's really.
That's what I'm saying. Why everybody want Angel to go to Atlanta so bad? They have the 12th pick. She's not going. She's not going. Number 12. She's not.
Get 2,500 total cash allowance on this Equinox.
Who trade? If Washington trade
Chevrolet together, this let's pick. Drive.
Well, do not
Matt ain't even gonna be the word.
Second of the most anticipated season yet. Follow these rookies with WNBA League Pass and stream live games.
She's not going number 7 either.
Scan the QR.
I don't see. I'm saying. I'm really like
today. Four picks down, fifth pick coming.
All right, so I'm going to say it like this. If they pick up Angel, if Dallas pick up Angel right here, right? That means we get Aaliyah Edwards. We get Aaliyah Edwards. Which is not bad because Aaliyah Edwards is doing her doggone thing when you come. Her page was, you feel me?
It is dealing with some
and that's why Dallas put Atlanta out the playoffs last season. Because y'all want Angel so bad.
After watching the playoffs,
now y'all can have them. Y'all gonna have them on the wrong team.
Their small guards like, were exposed in their second round loss to the Vegas.
So that's what I'm saying. Dallas need a guard.
Injury.
Okay.
Curious how long she will be out. That might they make them look for a power get, forward, but like Aaliyah Edwards. But
they can get Jay Shelton for real.
She Sheldon would certainly fit that bill.
Yeah, I mean,
they can get Jay Shelton.
Was 3-point shooting. When you
thank you. Somebody else agree with me. Angel got to come back home. Angel got to come home.
Per game, so a big guard that can knock down threes. Defense.
Yes, I actually do because Caitlin, if she go into the league and do what she did in college, I'm telling you.
With the number 5 overall pick of the 2024 WNBA.
They gonna have a star on their hands in Indiana. All right, come on, let's go.
With the 5th pick
do me right.
In the 2024 WNBA draft, the Dallas Wings select J.C. Sheldon, Ohio State
University. In a way, I didn't. Listen, Angel is still on the board. Well, Washington, do your thing. I didn't expect Jason Sheldon. I ain't gonna lie.
At Ohio State,
I was expecting Aaliyah Edwards.
Last year, a deep tournament run. You talked about the
Angel, listen, Washington. If you're Sheldon in this lab right now, and y'all so want to know who y'all should pick,
to be a
please pick Angel. I was not expecting JC to go this high in the draft. Really, I ain't gonna lie.
This is a veteran, played her entire 5-season career at Ohio State. She's a bucket. 2026 career.
I wouldn't expect her to go this high in the draft.
In Ohio State history, but for me,
I was not.
Her speed, the energy that
I ain't expect her to go to number 8.
To the court, it's relentless. She gets
I do see the fever making
down shots.
Running the playoffs. How deep their run is, I don't know.
Defensive mind. She has a high motor, plays with energy on both ends of the floor.
Okay, JC.
Nice driving ability. Puts
all right, you a little three, bucket.
Really
okay.
Ball screens as well.
Okay.
Get to her mid-range.
They say they need a point guard.
The Dallas Wings.
Wings.
She 5'10". They said they needed a point guard.
I want to start with your family. So, your dad's a basketball coach. Your mom was a terrific track athlete. They have instilled in you to be a terrific athlete.
Please don't let Angel go number 6.
39.
Please let Angel go number 6.
How have they helped make you the player?
To Washington.
Oh my gosh, they're everything. They've done so much for
me. I need Washington to do their big one.
My college career and really my whole life, but they mean everything to me.
You hold on, y'all.
Dallas Wings team, and they are a team that needs scoring on the perimeter, but you've got Arike Ogunbowale. How can you fit in and flow with someone that likes the ball in their hands and can score, but you assist at a high level? Absolutely. I'm really excited, especially the love for the game that we all share. I think it's going to be really fun to compete out there and just push each other to be better. I know that Emma is dying to get over here. She is waiting. You are the best cheerleader ever. She really has been your best cheerleader this whole career, 5 years at Ohio State. How has she lifted you?
In so many ways. She's been a huge impact on me and my family, and she has no idea, and it's been cool to see really the whole world, just to see how special she is and how much of an impact she makes.
We've all fallen in love with you, and you yell during opponents' free throws, and you cause a lot of people to miss. I noticed that, so great job by you. Are you proud of her?
Yeah.
All right, I'm back.
All right, well, thank you. Oh,
that's so cute.
To all of you. Thank you.
The best overall player in my eyes, Asia Wilson. I ain't gonna lie. Mystics, please.
Washington Mystics on the clock with the number 6 overall pick. We know this is a Washington team that played a tight little 2-game series with New York last year in the playoffs, but they've now had significant pieces.
Angel to go to Washington.
Cloud, Don, Elena Deladon not playing this season, so interesting how Washington
Indiana
has to sort of rebuild or look at their future in a different way.
Not too much on Angel going to Washington, okay?
Turning piece though is Shakira Austin. This is a young woman who has a future.
Y'all doing the doggone pack. Okay.
Is a player who can complement her, play alongside her.
Atlanta
looking for a stretch
is number 12.
Would certainly fit.
Angel's not going that.
A player like
Angel's not going to be in that draft room that long. Please listen. I don't let Aaliyah go number 7. I need Angel to go number 6, please.
The way they pass, the way they find each other, also their energy on the boards together could be huge. And the one thing I know is whatever rookie ends up going to Washington,
y'all, don't say that. Don't jinx that, okay? Don't jinx that. Don't jinx that.
Up for their team.
They see a stretch 4, please. Get Angel. Please.
All right, we're going to see if that's exactly what happens here with a little 4-5 punch. The pick is in.
Please be Angel.
To the podium is the commissioner with the selection.
Don't, please. Washington, please.
With the 6th pick in the 2024 WNBA draft, the Washington Mystics select Aaliyah Edwards, University of Connecticut.
Right now, as Edwards goes to Washington and will be Shakira Austin's teammate with that 4-5 punch in the front court. Big hugs all the way around for Aaliyah Edwards, as she has so many of her contingent in the building, teammates, coaching staff.
The only one I got right. The only one I got right was Caitlin Clark so far.
Aaliyah Edwards, after such a steady, successful career at Connecticut, back in the Final Four this season, after so many
Washington, you had one job.
Make a run like
I'm not saying anything wrong with Aaliyah Edwards. She's my player, phenomenal. I can't gap. She's a phenomenal player. Like I said, her and Paige Buckets was doing a double thing. But y'all missed some storylines that could have been made. So now. Now, Angel's gonna go number 7. And you know where she's going? To Minnesota. So, have fun in Minnesota, Angel. I don't know what to tell you.
Drives well from the free throw line as well.
Oh, because they had like the top picks in the last 2 drafts.
And again, we've already said it, but we love it when the stats support it. Washington's
they had a top pick in the last 2 or 3 drafts, I want to say.
Rebounds per game. Aaliyah
so
Edwards and Shakira Austin.
I'm not disappointed because Aaliyah Edwards is a nice player. So I see her and Shakira Austin doing the doggone thing. But
it is hard when you hear that name called. You just get kind of overwhelmed.
I ain't finna go to Minnesota. Whew.
I can take a breath now. Oh my God.
Angel's gonna be next. I don't see Angel going at 12. Y'all, I don't think y'all gonna be realistic here. She's not going. She gonna be in the top 10.
It means
even if she go 10. Hold on, Dallas had two picks. I forgot Dallas had two picks too.
Your mom was your coach as a kid. Your brother helped coach you. You guys have.
Y'all bet on she don't go number 9 and go to Dallas.
What did they coach you to do to be such a consistent? Excellent player. I just think of consistency.
Jace Carson.
I mean, Jace Sheldon. Knew me pretty well because they were family first and foremost. But yeah, excellence and just building the foundation into the player that I am. I had to push myself. You know, being a coach's kid is.
I ain't going so
it's
sorry.
A lot of expectations, but I pride myself on.
I expected them to do the doggone thing.
You have held yourself to a high standard, and I want to talk about your Canadian team.
I don't know at this point.
There's a lot of kids in Canada watching tonight. You've been on the senior national team.
Welcome to the family. I ain't gonna lie, y'all. I'm disappointed.
How are you inspiring?
I needed Washington. LA didn't pick up Angel.
Oh my gosh, it's an overload of love and mad
love. I'm disappointed.
From
I can't.
Across the border, I get so many messages and support, and I feel all the love. But I'm just really grateful to make an impact here.
She's gonna go to Minnesota. I don't see her going to Chicago either. This is what I'm saying. DeMarco would have been so nice when Angel came to Washington. She would have been seen as like the hometown hero. The one to take the mister to the next level.
Okay,
ooh,
I think it's a pretty quick
they messed it up.
Washington for Canada. So we'll get some Canadians down there.
Bring all the Canadians to Washington. Let's go.
I'm going to miss this game this year. So I'm going to see a little Edwards, but hey.
Chicago is on the clock at 7 because of a recent trade.
That's what I'm saying. She must have got hurt or something. But no, I take that back. She did get hurt
they get a swap
in the tournament. She hurt her ankle.
Look at this trade. Moving on,
I forgot about that.
Just one pick.
She's not going to Atlanta.
Hey, Chicago has someone in mind that they thought wasn't going to make it past 7. That they want to take right here.
And when you talk to teams around the league, everyone thought that Chicago was coveting Angel Reese. And so would Angel Reese have gotten past the 7th pick if they hadn't made that trade? Probably not. This is a Chicago team, even though they already have gotten a big, they can get bigger. So that would be the anticipated pick.
And again, what did we talk about earlier with the head coach leading the way and Teresa Weatherspoon to pour into Angel Reese, teach defense, energy, confidence,
man, I'm just
those things, those two combined, if this
right
ends up being the pick, could be really tough for a
I don't even want to see against. I want to see Camilla and Angel go at it. I don't want to see them together. Okay,
find out now. The 7th pick is in. Back to the podium goes Kathy Engelbert.
The Chicago Sky trading
pick in the 2024 WNBA draft, the Chicago Sky select Angel.
God dog it! Why would they do that? Come on! I didn't want to see that duo. I wanted to see them against each other. Come on! Alright. I told y'all she wouldn't go to Atlanta. I don't know why y'all really thought she wouldn't go to Atlanta. She's not going to Atlanta. I told y'all.
A double-double machine. Her head coach Kim Mulkey here to celebrate. At 34 double doubles last season, the most in a single season in D1 history.
I'm so disappointed.
An All-American SEC player of the year, and now Angel Reese.
It's gonna be a nice duo. I can't count because they both some phenomenal players. So it's like
when it comes to passion and energy and love for the game, Angel.
She just got traded. Minnesota had the 7th pick, but they don't trade. They pick to Chicago, so she already got traded already. She's not going
to. She's committed already to putting her to putting into her game will keep her.
I'm so disappointed.
What do you call her? Angel Relentless Reese.
Well, she calls herself a
I'm so sad.
That's certainly the type of player that Teresa Weatherspoon can build around. She's strong, explosive, and elite.
Man, Teresa Weatherspoon gonna have she got some people on her hands.
This is a great fit for Angel Reese because it's crazy. Also a Chicago team that could potentially keep both of them.
So now Minnesota.
All right,
I mean,
Angel Reese is with Holly Rowe.
Yeah, Minnesota next, right? They got the 8th pick, right? Somebody gonna pick up the other girl. The girl from, oh my goodness. What is her name?
So exciting. I get to play with Camilla. I've been playing against her since high school. So I'm excited to play with Camilla, and Teaspoon is amazing, and she's done some great things, and I'm excited to be coached by her.
Man,
the thing that I've admired,
I ain't gonna lie, this season's gonna be amazing.
Career from high school,
this WNBA season,
you win.
Chef's kiss. I ain't gonna lie.
Infuse that winning style and culture to Chicago.
I gotta see that. Like,
so just coming in and being competitive, having an open mind every day to just want to work, and I'm just excited to learn from my vets.
You I don't need no trade talk. If Angel go anywhere, she better be traded to Washington. That we're having on this I know trip. That.
What are you proud of that you've
she better be traded to Washington. Right, she might not be traded to Atlanta. She's going to do that now. What's she going to do with Atlanta? Nothing. She's going to go to Atlanta.
I came from Baltimore, not supposed to be here. And it's happy. And my mom is here. And my
Angel, stop crying, girl. I'm going to give you a hug. You should have came to Washington. But that's all right. You, it's cool. I ain't gonna hold it over you. It's not your fault.
The seventh overall pick of the 2024 WNBA draft gets a big hug.
Folks in a pack of skip. Hey, Tony, get out. That's what I'm saying. She should have went to Washington. It would have been so meaningful to her to go to Washington. Think about it. She from Baltimore, Maryland. She got her start at Maryland. Come on. It's a no-brainer. Duh.
Okay, I'll shoot.
What's happening?
But I don't see any hoop.
No, I said that because of, I'm sorry, shoot.
Where's the hoop?
They don't have one.
You stop saying the S
word. I don't know.
They're going to want the jingle for this.
Okay. She but better not get tried. If Angel goes
don't worry.
To Atlanta.
State Farm makes it easy to file a claim on the app.
If Angel get traded to Atlanta, I'll file that Atlanta to go to one of the games.
Someone call for an old pacer?
If Angel get traded to Atlanta.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Something?
Test me. NBA play intern, Heat, Sixers, and Hawks, Bulls on ESPN.
Where grace meets grit.
Championship is going to go down right now.
And perfection is an art. The NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship semifinals.
My whole on ESPN mock draft messed up. Plus. Who I got left though?
Doug.
Still got Dasha Fair.
It's Doug.
Alyssa, that's her name. The Alyssa girl.
Anyway,
they need to go and pick up. But I don't know who else need a big. She don't need to go to New York.
Sure, I can hold.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty.
Ghostbusters Frozen Empire in theaters now.
Hey guys, ESPN Bet is here. Finally, a sports book from your favorite sports brand. Now you can take in all this ESPN content.
I appreciate the follow. Welcome to the family.
Market you see in the ESPN
thank you for tuning in. We just got disappointed. Angel is on her way to Chicago.
Like an intuitive design so, and tons of boosts and promotions for your favorite ESPN personalities, including me. So, what are you waiting for? Download today.
Welcome back to the WNBA Draft 2024, presented by State Farm.
I want to go on Twitter right now.
Experience the historic and record-breaking college basketball seasons of
y'all. We really gonna put Cardoso and Angel Reese together.
The anticipated ESPN Plus original series, Full Court Press, presented by State Farm, premiering May 11th exclusively on ABC and streaming on ESPN. Plus,
I know they loving it, but
on,
I can't, man.
Down, and now the Minnesota Lynx with the 8th selection. This is the Lynx.
All right, Minnesota, what y'all need?
Selection. Now in that 8th spot,
Minnesota could have had Angel. Look at y'all now, looking crazy.
Able to fully rebuild.
Looking too good at bonkers right now.
And just competing.
Y'all should have kept it.
So here they are at 8. They also get the swap in that deal with Chicago for 2026. Where
what you mean going on trip? I told y'all. If Angel get traded to Atlanta, I'll come to Atlanta to a game.
Courtney Williams and Natisha Heideman to join Kayla McBride.
If Angel get traded to Atlanta, I'll go to Atlanta for a game.
They got Diamond Miller.
Now I got to plan a trip to Chicago to go see her and Camilla because they wanted to do that.
This year, they
just, you know, they wanted to put them together so bad.
Trade, but when you look at their needs, they look like they need a front court player, a rebounder, a player who just shores up their front line.
Yeah, in the front court. If they could combine those two things, maybe a stretch big, someone that could knock down threes, defensive minded, of course. When you're playing for Cheryl Reeve, this is a storied organization.
Y'all might get Deja Fair
to win championships. So a tough, gritty player that's a winner is going to be important here.
Not that far removed from four titles in a 7-year period. Back to the podium. The pick is in.
All right, who going to Minnesota?
Commissioner Kathy Engelbert with the selection.
Who going to Minnesota?
With the eighth pick in the 2024 WNBA draft, the Minnesota Lynx select Alyssa Pelley.
I knew it. That girl there? Whoa, beast, I'm telling you.
So Alyssa Pelley, she good. Minnesota. This is a player who is such an efficient scorer everywhere.
I'm from Mississippi, but I live in Maryland right now.
And Rebecca, you saw her play.
And most definitely watching games this season. Really, I'm actually trying to go to some Mystics game this year. That's on my calendar.
Offensive player.
So yeah.
Very much looking forward to seeing
her. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing her because she did her doggone thing. Appreciate the follow. Welcome to the family.
Alyssa Pelley is the most She's on my radar. 6 feet tall, but she can score on
DMV, you know what it is. I'm trying to go to the Mystic game. So you trying to go with me to the Mystic games? Slide with me. We going to the Mystic game.
Which is something that
listen, look at that. Big girl, listen.
She got her own, right? You know, what's really special, we talked about three-point shooting. 55% from the field this season, 30% from three. She has the ability to stretch the floor. She is also physical. She works.
You got Angel and Camilla on the same team. They finna be fighting each other for the rebounds. What are you saying?
In D1 over the last two seasons, and Alyssa,
like you, they gonna be fighting for the ball. Like what?
Keely, you have come so far.
Not bad though. But they gonna be going there tonight.
I know your whole family is here. Tell me what it
means. But who you gonna put at the power forward though? Never mind, you can put Angel at the four and Camilla at the five.
Everything to me, and they've helped me get here.
That's another girl I think you talk about.
And, you know, I love everything to them.
That's the other girl for Iowa State. I've seen you play the one you talk about,
Tony.
There
are lines and lines and lines of people to get.
I couldn't even count. They definitely, from your the twin towers out there. It's crazy.
Heritage and your indigenous heritage. How are you inspiring people who are like you that this is possible? Great.
You know, a lot of indigenous and Polynesian girls don't get to see that role model, and I'm just so blessed that I could be in the position to be that for them.
I love your beautiful.
You did it, girl. Yes. Most definitely. You deserve it. Because you played, you did your doggone thing. No, I can't lie.
Special to you tonight. How are you representing?
She did her doggone thing.
I'm just representing them with pride. You know, I had to include the tribal in my dress.
Girl. You on my radar. I ain't gonna lie.
You know, everything it took to get here, their support just pushed
Angel
me
is not, and, I'm telling
you.
Know,
really excel me to get to this.
If Angel get traded.
Okay, I'm gonna quote Dawn Staley. They played
appreciate the follow.
She said,
thank
we
you.
We can't stop her.
If Angel get traded to my Atlanta, I'm gonna come to Atlanta to a game.
Congratulations to Coach Lynn Roberts at Utah who helped pour into you. How will you immediately impact the league?
I think it's my physicality and my versatility.
We're gonna see.
I'm willing to do we whatever are going to see. To, so I'm excited to.
Because it's still time. Like you said, it's still time for the trade talk.
Cheryl Reeve is
but I don't see the trade.
I know her style, and she is going to love you, which is why she's
definitely the David Robinson and Tim Duncan duo. Definitely. They going ham in the paint. Right, what?
Man, the
folks, no folks, they don't know what to do with Angel. And Camilla, they don't know what to do. They don't know what to do. It's over with. All right, who Dallas picking up?
With the ninth pick in the 2024 WNBA draft,
who you got?
The Dallas Wings select Carla Late from France.
I don't know who that is.
This is certainly
have no idea who that is.
Where teams start looking for players
okay.
for the future, and Late is one
Hold
of those.
On.
She's only 20 years old. A true point
she
guard.
She's 20 years old now.
Having a ton of wiggle. wiggle to her game.
Yeah, no, I have no idea. I don't know who that is. Which is no surprise because she so she's coming from overseas. Free throw lines and she led the French. All right, appreciate you for coming in. You have a great night. Really thank you for stopping by and joining the fam. Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Where she just didn't give up on the ball, she pursues it. She is
hey. Getting downhill. Getting into don't say that though.
Finding her team. Think about her playing potentially with Arike Ogunbowale, playing with the post.
I would definitely say she going to play Arike Ogunbowale. So
like you said, Rebecca, for the future,
they may be a nice little duo. The 10th overall. I don't know how that's gonna go though. Cause the Dallas. I want to say they did a run in the playoffs.
To the tippy top of the
so, oh, appreciate it. Thank you so much.
See, they lost in the finals in an epic five.
Have a great night.
Washington in 2019. Then semifinals. Back
don't,
to the
Skylar Diggins still play for Connecticut? Hold on.
Semifinal loss in a hard-fought series against New York a season ago. You see over the last 5 years their success.
Hold on.
But Rebecca, this might be the final run for serious members of this group
may
to
be
able to play together for Connecticut.
Yeah, they have the core pieces that have helped them.
Connecticut
have so
might got a nice pick
years,
on their
most of those pieces are free
because
agents after this season. This is a team that does not have a lot of holes
to
fill.
No.
Wouldn't be surprised if they too took a pick for the future, but
we
yes,
gotta
you
see.
Wonder, is this the last season that they'll have that core group together because so many are free agents?
And whoever it is has to be defensive-minded. This is a team that forced 15 turnovers a game, scored 18 and a half points off of those turnovers. If
for
you know
real?
Anything,
Connecticut
love to play
defense. Who all, so hold on, wait, who all them? Who all them?
A lot of defensive film is what they paid attention
who
to.
Who all
them? Right, the selection is in. Who does Connecticut take?
Who they, are they gonna pick up? They gonna, they need a big? Charisma being, ain't it? I don't think
with
so.
With the 10th pick in the 2024 WNBA Draft,
who yeah?
The Connecticut Sun select Layla Lacan from France.
I have no idea who that is.
So
they from the same team?
With back-to-back picks.
Okay, friends.
Layla Lacan is 5'11", a big guard who is a good...
She wasn't even on my list.
Driver. She is... was told to me my most skilled and
I still got Daisy Fur Charisma Osborne
speeds well good at reading ball screens
Isabel
player that you don't expect
they ain't got picked yet
right away can continue to develop and learn and be ready when she joins the WNBA.
Please go watch the U19 World Championship game against Japan. She took over in that
I'm gonna have to go watch her highlights cuz I have I don't know what it is.
I said oh she kind of
I'm gonna have to go watch her highlights.
Tiffany Hayes, who just
she's new to me. She wasn't on my list.
And her ability to get down
yeah, her name's not on my list. It's okay.
Her ability to hit threes. It's a tough.
It's okay. I'm a put her on my radar. Team,
but ceiling wise, she has a great
so New York.
Set, great length, and she's defensive mindset.
I don't think New York could have picked up no point guard.
Sure, up next, the New York Liberty got back to the finals this past season.
They can pick up Marquisha Davis.
Do it again.
The Liberty can pick up Marquisha Davis. I don't see them picking up no point guard though.
We find out next.
I don't know. Angel's not getting traded. Why do y'all keep saying that? Angel is not going to Atlanta. Okay? There is no need for Angel in Atlanta. Okay. Hear me out. What Angel gonna do in Atlanta? Y'all got Ryan Howard. Ryan Howard took y'all to the first round of the playoffs. Okay? Now, what I will say, okay? Do Atlanta need a big?
How much is the Brinsley?
Yes.
It's market price.
Do I need somebody to rebound? Most definitely.
How much a fish costs?
But y'all don't need Angel Reese.
Ma'am, you can't.
Y'all don't need Angels.
CarMax has test drives.
You can't have
right, all she's gonna do is get in trouble. She ain't gonna do it. They gonna basically try to market this girl the whole time she in the room.
I hate this trip.
She'll be alright. She is okay in Chicago. I'm alright now. I really would have wanted her to go to Atlanta. I mean, I said I want her to go to Atlanta. I don't want her to go to Atlanta. I want her to go to Washington.
I don't know where to begin.
Toby, eat your breakfast.
Maybe I just smell it.
No, she definitely will be a star in Atlanta, though. But she don't need to be.
It ain't my dad's razor, Dad. Hey, watch it. It's from Gillette Labs.
This cream bar. I hope this don't get in trouble in Chicago. What I'm saying is, Angel don't need to be a star player right now.
For the ultimate Gillette shaving experience.
She needs to be a support. Like, it don't need to all be on her like it was at LSU. Like, everything that went right or wrong with LSU was on Angel. So if Angel goes to Atlanta, that's going to be the same thing. Everything that goes right or wrong in Atlanta is going to be on Angel. So she don't need to be in Atlanta. She need, like, she needs to stay in Chicago. That way I can be her and Camilla. Do I see them going to the playoffs? I ain't gonna lie. I see Indiana going in the playoffs.
This is the super team era now.
I see if Chicago keep Angel and Camilla, I see Chicago going into the playoffs.
I think us being able to team up.
I don't think she needs to be the only star on the team right now.
Really special about this.
I mean, like, she needs help. You get what I'm saying? To help, like, cause this is gonna be her first season. She gonna have to. Because Caitlin finna catch it.
We grew as a team a lot. That should give us a lot of confidence and motivation to build on what we started this year.
They will trade their whole team for Caitlin Clark. It's crazy.
The building here tonight was just getting crazy. The crowd going. Yeah, there's Ellie. Gets a little wild with that trunk from time to time. This crowd is certainly livened up. We felt the atmosphere at Barclays Center. Which was,
I don't think Chicago missing the playoffs. I don't see it.
Here you can feel the energy of these Liberty.
I do not see Chicago missing the playoffs.
We also know it's a New York team.
Chicago definitely. I don't. Now how deep they going to playoffs? I don't know.
Splashiest off season.
Yeah, I knew the elephant was coming because it's. And come on now.
To get over the top.
And they certainly feel good about the needs that they did fill through free agency.
That would be the final of the season.
This is a pick
in Indiana, Phoenix, Chicago, with Angelus and Camilla both going against Caitlin.
When I was talking to New York, Markeisha Davis was a player.
They ain't got to worry about Reyes.
Didn't think that she would sky be high. Here. Because
that would be crazy. That would be a crazy fight.
Markeisha Davis, the coach sitting right next to her, Coach Hill, all they preach at Ole Miss is defense. I got a t-shirt from Ole Miss that said on the front, "We defend." That's all that was on the t-shirt. When you talk about it,
I think Markeisha Davis going next.
Perimeter defense. Markeisha Davis.
To New York. I see her going to New York. How long she stand in New York, I don't know. Because I forgot about Brittany Stewart in New York. All right, let's see who they got. Who y'all got? Let's go.
With the 11th pick in the 2024 WNBA Draft, the New York Liberty select Markeisha Davis.
I figured it.
University of Mississippi.
You better put on for Ole Miss, girl. Appreciate the follow. Thank you. Welcome in. Welcome to the family. Now, my thing is, right, the New York Liberty is stacked, okay? So when I say this girl gonna be fighting for her spot, I just don't want her to be another Alexa Moores. Appreciate the follow. Welcome to the family. Welcome in. Welcome to the family.
That went to the finals a season ago. That has so much talent, so much
Valley
to learn from as well.
Be free.
Davis stays right here.
Who Valley got?
Going to New York and gets
the name one.
To the podium to grab her New York.
They could draft in Sydney. This about it. Sydney. Yeah, that's it.
Markeisha Davis could be one of the best athletes in the draft. A number of coaches and GMs compare her to colleagues.
If Serena
6 feet tall, she is an elite
get
athlete,
a team.
Good in
I need to get an expansion team. I don't need her to get a team that's already here. Right? I want her to get an expansion team. And I want her to pick up people who got weight. Like Alexis Moore, she need to get picked up. What's the other girl? The other girl from South Carolina that got waived last year, she need to get picked up. I need Serena to come in. If she own a team, I need her to get a team that's rebuilding. So a team that Serena can like own now, I would say.
Well, Davis is
welcome to the family. Appreciate the follow.
So
So we were talking earlier. Mm. And you said
who can she own now? That's a rebuilding team. Minnesota.
3,650.
Minnesota will be a good rebuild team.
Coming out of that town, so not many kids come out of that town to get to stand on a stage like this tonight.
Seattle will be a good rebuild team.
I'm very proud, you know, to come from a small town and to dream big, and you know, to
you better talk, girl.
It's not always easy, so I would just say to those young girls that dream big, but they're from a small town, always believe and just keep going.
Amen.
So beautifully said. Amen. And you have a special why you play basketball, why you are such a great two-way player and play as hard as you do. What is your why?
I would say that my why is my family, because I do this for them and I want to provide a better life for them.
Wonderful. And how fun is it that you get some of your own hometown fans? Like, let's turn around and say, hello, New York Liberty. This is her.
Oh, wow. Man, I should have went to the draft live. It's okay, though. Next year, I'm going. Because guess what? All-Star weekend. I'm going All-Star weekend, y'all. Catch me in Phoenix for WNBA All-Star weekend.
How wonderful is that moment here with the Liberty fans embracing...
All right, Atlanta, you're up now. Atlanta, you're up now. Y'all the last pick of the first round, so hope y'all get somebody nice. Well, shoot, y'all think you get Deja Fair. Or Charisma Osborne.
About a decade ago, we saw them go to the finals many times.
I'm them two friends. People threw my whole list off. I was not expecting them.
How about how they continue to build on the recent success they've had?
You know, I mean,
there is no trade. Oh my goodness, there is no trade
on the boards. What did they do?
No person getting traded. It's Kaylin. She can get traded to Atlanta
and bring a solution to
let Kaylin go to Atlanta.
Inside presence and their size. So I wonder if Atlanta is looking at a guard, maybe a backup point guard, someone to play. They lost Ari McDonald. They got Jordan Canada. I think a guard would be a good fit. Got to know how to play defense. Again, it's Atlanta, but I'm thinking a guard here.
Mm-hmm. They did a nice job filling their needs in free agency, because when
I think they're going to pick up that. They got Dave Fred. They got Charisma Osborne, because they're still on my list.
They get Tina Charles, and former MVP.
Isabel.
Canada, one of the most improved players in the Liberty League. And Ariel
I'm telling y'all, if I ain't to get traded to Atlanta, I'll come to Atlanta for a game.
Of veteran additions to their
tell
team.
Me.
All right, we're going to find out who the selection is. The final pick of the first
round. Final pick of the first round, y'all.
NBA draft is in.
Who we got?
Here is Kathy Engelbert.
Who Atlanta got? Here go Atlanta.
With the
12th who y'all got?
In the 2024 WNBA draft, the Atlanta Dream select Nadia Poch from Australia.
Okay, she was on my list. She actually was on my list to go number 12. She has some nice highlights. Y'all got a big. Yay, Atlanta. Y'all don't need Angel no more now. Y'all got a big.
So Nadia Poch, who played in the WNBL with the Southside Flyers.
In the final pick. Chill out. First round headed to the Atlanta. Y'all got a big. Y'all don't need Angel no more.
More and more seeing international players.
Y'all don't need Angel no more. Y'all got a big. Yay, y'all. Yay, Atlanta. Oh, my goodness. I'm so happy for y'all. Yay, Atlanta. Oh, my goodness.
Long, athletic, rangy. She can score at different levels. Top-notch speed driving to the
she gonna dunk for y'all, bro. Come on. Go, girl. There.
Also can hit the corner three.
There you go. Y'all got a big. Look at, she can block. Y'all got a big. Y'all don't need Angel no more.
With Poch, and she talked about two
players. Let's go.
Her game after being
let's go, Poch.
Because of the way they
let's go, Poch.
Length, and that's on both ends.
Yeah.
One of my favorite parts of her game.
Look at that.
Size. But she drops her shoulders. She's a physical driver. She puts
look at that. Well, y'all got a big. Y'all good.
Holly Ruff.
Let's go, Poch.
Well, one of the most unique parts of your game, you're 19 years old, but you've
that's what I'm saying. Y'all got what y'all need. Appreciate the follow. Welcome to the family.
Championship team this year. How big is your upside when you're just getting started in the W at just 19?
That is true. I feel like they don't want competition in the WBA.
I still got development to get through, you know, experiences and stuff. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I think I can learn more, add more to my game.
Mm-hmm. Keep going.
You got to play alongside Lauren Jackson, one of the greats of the WNBA. Mercedes Russell on this team with you in the Southside Flyers this year. What was some advice they gave you about being a pro in this league?
Y'all got y'all a big.
She talked to me.
Y'all doing a doggone thing.
She's great. Back in Australia.
There is no trade announcement.
Yeah, she told me, like, they're gonna break me. You know, they're gonna push me. They're gonna come at me. You know, but you just gotta keep going, build yourself, and just keep being relentless.
How resilient would you describe yourself as?
I think I'm good, pretty good. Yeah.
So they are not.
Girl, you better be confident.
They're not gonna break you.
You better tell the folks in Atlanta.
Mom, just tears coming down her face. You have 7 siblings in your family. No. All of you play basketball.
Mm-mm. Oh, snap.
This moment for your family.
All right.
Yeah, well, it's huge. We big family.
Y'all.
Basketball, and you know, my mom. Oh, we're gonna cry.
Don't cry, girl. Don't cry, girl.
It's okay.
My mom, she's done so much for us.
It's okay. If you're not crying, then it didn't mean anything, right? It's a beautiful moment. Tell your mom.
Y'all want to know some? The Mystics
so strong.
She's got they pick mom. From Atlanta. So Atlanta could have had the 8th pick.
After us, done a lot for us. And
I'm so sorry for y'all.
Traveling in New York, watching me doing this, and yeah, it's cool. It's very cool.
Yo, listen, y'all would have had the 8th pick.
Oh, what a beautiful moment! That is what this night is all
so
about.
So y'all would have got
professional dreams come true.
Alyssa. Y'all had the 8th pick, but y'all traded it to, actually y'all traded to Chicago, but Chicago traded their pick. I mean, Chicago traded their pick with Minnesota. So, y'all would have had a list.
First overall selection, she will join our desk in a little bit. How about Cameron Brink getting hugs? So many different players celebrating this wonderful evening.
Yeah, so, well, that's the first... The first round of the WNBA draft.
Hello. Aloha.
So.
Howdy. Hey, y'all. And welcome to the W. Here in the W, we pride
this is an interesting draft.
Super welcoming. Calm. Low stakes environment.
It was a draft. That's what I say.
Communication is highly important. Collaboration is always encouraged.
Oh, what a pick.
We are devoted to working extra, extra hard.
This has been a crazy draft.
Since 1997.
I don't know what to do.
This is a place where
this draft all over the place.
And if you love real,
I don't know, y'all. I'm just I'm baffled.
Welcome to the W.
That's what I don't know. Like, this whole, like, the whole draft, it messed me up because a lot of the picks, like, Jay Shelton, I didn't know she was going that high in the draft. I was expecting Daisha Fair to go in the first round, but she going in the second. Isabelle, I was expecting her to go in the first round. She going in the second.
That's the powerful
Charisma ain't going the first round. So I'm like I said, the whole first round is throwing me off. So I don't know how the second round finna go because it's like
from your PenFed checking and savings accounts.
They still got some heavy hitters. That still ain't been drafted.
Dreams will always be worth it.
I got it.
I'm over it.
So what do you think?
Because none of the picks.
Well, the vets have been there before.
Well, I mean, we got Cameron Brink to LA.
It's playoffs. So
and Rakeem Jackson. I'm alright with that. That's a decent pair.
You really think experience will make a difference,
Frank?
It's the playoffs.
But this Angel Reese and Camilla, I don't know how I feel about that.
It's the playoffs.
How about a box of
words? I'm at a loss of words when it comes to that.
Absolutely. It's the playoffs.
Yeah, y'all would have had y'all would have had a listen. Welcome you to the second round of the WNBA draft. I'm sorry, Tonio. Y'all still got a nice pick though. It's not a bad. Like, she's not bad. This moment for this talented young class led by that woman, Caitlin. Chicago up next. I don't think they need no. They finna get a point guard. They don't need another big. After her incredibly scintillating collegiate career. That's true, because they finna be the Twin Towers. Is headed to Indiana. It's the sky. Second round tote board as we get ready to begin. And look, we have seen several significant pieces. Like the girl from UConn, Nika. I don't know what's her name. I'm just distraught by this whole first round. I don't know. MVP in Washington. How about here, Banaja Laney Hamilton? I'm just ready for the season to start at this point. All I know is when I go to this mixed game on the 8th, I need Leah Edwards to show up and show out. Because we done picked you. All right now. Yeah, now her going in the second round is crazy. Because she was going. She was balling hard at UConn. But then again, I don't know. I don't know when I'm hopping on the game, Tony. I'm probably going to hop on for a little bit after this draft. I'm just... That could still end up having not only great careers, but immediate impacts.
Yeah, certainly. And you heard our.
That's what I'm thinking. A lot of the teams that need a guard. Important it is because in terms of this fit. Whole so when you're looking at the first round, thinking, mainly been bigs that have got picked. To camp and really the only and in particular, if you're in the point guards that have been picked maybe I'm going was 14 Marquisha Davis, J.C. Shipp.
Because they did not have first round picks, and then you have a broader opportunity to make the roster in camp.
Yeah, I think the mindset that you go in with, the confidence. Learning. Again, I keep referencing Dawn
Sandy. I don't know, man. She was on set
with us earlier. She just talked about being a sponge. And when you come into the league and you have that sponge mindset, learn all that you can, pay attention to the small
this
details.
Whole draft
you
threw
can
me
stick
out.
In this league, do the things that you do best, bring positive I'm at a loss energy. For these are great opportunities. Again, we talked about it.
Chicago where finna you get a big. I mean,
is the most important.
There's no need for right if now, Chicago now, pick another the big. Chicago Sky, the pick is in with the. They do not need another big. In the 2024 WNBA y'all got Camilla Angel. There's no need for another big. Y'all better get a point guard.
Gonzaga University. So Brenna is the 13th overall pick. Headed to the Chicago Sky. We know Chicago's already had a very busy night. We saw.
Is she 6 feet?
Second and fourth.
Is that another big? Why did I get another big?
And now they had a little more talent at 13th.
Yeah, a guard with good size who can really.
Oh, no, she's a guard. Okay, I was going to say.
At a Gonzaga team,
she's a guard, my bad. She ain't even there. So my thing is, y'all invited 15 girls.
So she knows how to play with other very good players.
So that made three of them new. Hey, I'm not going to go in the first round. Cool. But y'all still got these three girls that ain't been picked and y'all invited them to the draft. So we're.
What are some of the best three-point shots to hit? The ones
who was even that? I don't even know.
Great opportunity for Brenna to come in.
I don't even know who that was.
All right, well, you know, one team we have not talked
about. Brenna Maxwell? I don't know who that was.
They are now on the clock for the very first time. And we know.
All right, Seattle, who you picking?
It has been a busy offseason.
Seattle, who you picking? Y'all done got Neko Gumke already, so. It's finalized. Hope y'all have fun with Neko Gumke. Y'all took my favorite player. Neko Gumke has signed with me. I'm so disappointed that y'all took Nick over and came for me. Skylar Diggins signed to Seattle too. I thought she was still in Connecticut. Well, shoot. Seattle might be trying to make a run. I don't know. I don't know. Is this the build of a super team for Seattle? Because what? Hopefully they pick up Deja Fair.
Breaking the news about her sister going to the Seattle Storm. And you also have to love the way the Storm have retooled here. After a down season last year, to be expected, after Sue Bird retires, after Breanna Stewart goes to New York, here the Storm are making serious additions.
This draft is just so...
Four championships, incredible investment from the franchise.
I'm hurting.
When it comes to practice facility, which is opening and everything else. And they got to be excited about this.
But it's all right.
A lot of times that I had Seattle games, I don't know, no one wanted to take the trip to
I ain't winning no free tickets for the Mystics. I got my whole first round on Seattle.
Their fans are so excited about this team. Even last season, there were times where Seattle was down, and they were down big. We had them a couple of times, and what did they do?
They fought.
Gosh,
they
battled. Dope.
They played with a ton of energy. They played around Jewel Lloyd. So you keep that fight.
I don't know
and
how
then
this.
You add pieces like
I don't know what's gonna happen next.
And Skylar Diggins Smith.
I don't know who's fight, gonna get picked.
Skill, experience.
This they still got three people in the room that haven't gotten picked though.
With those three pieces,
I'm definitely surprised they Charisma. I'm surprised she didn't get picked up in the first round. But like I was saying, it mainly was big that was picked in the first round. So it's like
that's not going to be the case this year. The Seattle fans last year, even when the team was struggling,
it's crazy if you do think about it, because a lot of teams did need bigs more than anything.
Yeah, we are not that far removed from Skylar Diggins Smith helping lead a team to the WNBA finals either. Remember that. Time to find out who the Storm are selecting.
Who y'all picking?
Back to the podium to cap the angle.
Pick up somebody nice.
With the 14th pick in the 2024 WNBA draft, the Seattle Storm select Nika Mule.
There y'all go. All right. Finally. I was expecting her to go first round. Finally.
number 10.
Okay.
Going to Seattle.
Okay.
It doesn't get much more poetic than
this. Is what I'm saying. Why is Deja Ferrer still on the board?
At the University of Connecticut is headed to
I don't know what Deja going. Hopefully she get picked next. Because like I said, they invited 15 girls.
Well, the Seattle Storm has
so it's two girls left in the building that haven't been drafted.
UConn players wearing their uniform. You mentioned Sue Bird, also Brianna Stewart helping them to a championship. And Nika Mule
let go, Flex.
Competitor that any team loves to have.
Sue, she I thought Sue retired.
At the guard position at 5'10".
Sue retired.
Was impressed
right?
The way she defended
so she
the
might.
Semifinals
listen.
At the Final Four.
I'm going to say this.
All over Caitlin Clark.
Being that Sue Bird just retired from this team.
She can make three-pointers.
She got a target on her back.
She will defend you anywhere on the floor, a tough competitor.
Because she got a lot to live up to. But she also got Skylar Diggins to play behind. Because Skylar Diggins is in Seattle now. So we're going to see how she does. She on my radar. I'm adding her to the radar. Because I didn't watch her that much until the tournament. The tournament I started watching her. So.
And she'll do that at Seattle.
I'm definitely surprised she went this low, though.
Big shot
big
as well.
Being that, you know, her tournament.
Is with Holly.
You know, her
well,
tournament
Nika, I know
play was
your
amazing.
Sister
so.
Hannah is here with you tonight, but the rest of your family are all at home in Croatia watching. What would you
yeah,
like to
yeah, it don't look like
right
she
now?
Going to Atlanta. So. Congratulations, girl. Welcome to Seattle. I do feel like she would have got distracted, but then again, I feel like she would have had a lot riding on her, being that she's gonna take would be the face of Atlanta, right behind,
that's my family.
Right behind Howard.
I want to give a message.
So it would have been, you know. Oh my goodness. This is going to be a season.
You broke Sue Bird's all-time assist record at UConn.
Oh,
now
snap.
You're going to Seattle where she is such a legend. How can you carry on?
Now she broke
a
record in college.
Legacy for the UConn Huskies.
Girl.
Oh my God. It's huge shoes to fill in. I feel like this my whole career.
Appreciate it. UConn have a good night.
Experience.
I'm probably about to get off this stream in a little bit, y'all. I'm just waiting for Deja Ferrer to get picked. Cause
I mean, I'm just excited to bring who I am to Seattle. I'm excited to bring.
I don't see why Deja Ferrer is still on the board right now.
I'm
not understanding why she's still on the board.
And everything else, I trust.
I don't know.
Coach Oriyama has been famous for pushing players. You're the first player that I've seen push Coach Oriyama.
I don't know.
How has he helped to build you into the player you are?
She might end up in Indiana. God. But then it's like, is she going to end up getting waived?
I mean, I am forever grateful to Coach, all my coaches, but specifically to him. He saw something in me. He brought me all the way to Croatia. It was a wild card. But I feel like
this
I can
is
say
crazy.
Payoff.
It definitely paid off. Congratulations, and have a great time in Seattle. You'll be fantastic.
Thank you so much.
I don't know.
What is
about to go on now? Because and then Charisma Osborne is still on the board too, from UCLA. So.
Indiana, we go back to the podium with the selection. Here is the commissioner.
All right, who Indiana picking up?
Who we are picking up? With the 15th pick in the 2024 WNBA draft, the Indiana Fever select Celeste Taylor, Ohio State University.
Not a bad pick. Not a bad pick. I forgot she was still on the board.
Celeste Taylor getting
not a bad pick.
She is headed to the Indiana Fever.
Okay.
Where she will join Caitlin Clark, already selected tonight. This is such a good defensive player of the year that she's won it in multiple conferences. The Big Ten defensive player of the year. This season, the SEC defensive player of the year. Last season, somebody who led the conference in steals this year and takes that skill set now to Indiana.
80 steals this season for Celeste.
God,
Indiana is getting a player that has a defensive 80? Mentality. She's
crazy.
Got quick hands. She's aggressive. She has great instincts. 80
steals?
She has a
wild
maturity about her. She plays under control.
Nah, she was on that.
So much energy, and she has elite speed getting up and down the floor.
80
to run
steals?
In transition. Find her
teammates,
and make impact defensively.
Where?
Exactly what Indiana's going to get.
And if you know anything about Linda, you know that she wants players who are willing and capable of defending, Dre. And Celeste Taylor certainly is that.
Okay.
Another big guard added to the backcourt of the Indiana Fever.
Two selections.
Indiana might have, I'm telling y'all.
The latest, she is with Holly Rowe.
This might be a good.
Remember the
I don't know how this WNBA season is going to go.
Texas. You blew me. Had a few stops in between, but every stop you found a way to shine. What is so special about you that whatever the situation, you find a way to be great in it?
Yeah, I mean, I just take a lot of pride
in it. I don't know what to say, y'all.
It's definitely a long road. My parents.
This gonna be a season.
As my backbone to continue to support.
Hey, y'all better start putting y'all parlays in.
It was hard.
I think that's what y'all be doing. Put y'all parlays in. Appreciate the follow. Thank you. Really appreciate
you
it so much.
The final stop
y'all
would
stop putting
your
parlays
state,
in.
And I hope you
do not put
question,
in that Kayla gonna go for 40 her first game.
Don't
do that.
How excited are
okay?
You will now be her teammate.
Think reasonable.
Yeah.
Well, I give her a 12 her first game.
You know,
12.
It's hard to guard her.
Don't go do no unreasonable. Don't have Angel grabbing 20 rebounds her first game. Let's think logically here, okay?
When
y'all put these parlays in.
It's gonna be amazing.
All right, you're known for your defense.
Y'all
getting
they finna play with grown women's now, okay? Listen, I'm gonna need y'all to think reasonable when y'all put these WNBA parlays in. Now with the NBA ones, you could do that. Don't.
She's got a mic. She's ready to go. She's gonna join our set next. That is up next here on ESPN.
Please don't have the Indiana Fever going undefeated this year. Don't do that either.
A proud change maker partner of the WNBA and Deloitte. Proud sponsor of the WNBA.
When do Vegas get a pick? I just thought about that. I ain't seen them pick.
Do you know
when do they pick? I ain't seen.
Do you know its condition?
Oh, they got the 18th pick. So Vegas got the 18th pick. So
who
they
knows?
Coming up.
Who cares?
Oh, wait, no, they got the 16th pick. They coming up next. My bad. Read too far. They got the 16th and 18th pick.
Your door to crisis breakfast.
They back to back WNBA champs. So I don't know.
Let's get this
because they still got a nice team.
You're on the clock,
so it's like,
I'm gonna go with Olivia Martinez, tech CEO, raised 3 rounds of funding.
Look at Sydney, I love
products,
Sydney. Cause and she's funny.
Show. Yeah, I'd definitely take over Chloe Thompson. Are you trying to reverse psychology me right now? Like, I don't know, Chloe up revenue by 11%, blocked 15 cyber breaches, and finished 10 digital transformations.
I don't know.
Another triple double.
This is gonna be one season, I tell you that. I'm ready for the WNBA season now. Can't wait. I need somebody to pick up Deja Fair though. Hopefully she can pick Nick. That's the last person I'm waiting on from my list. Oh, and Charisma Osborne. So I need, but I'm really waiting on Deja Fair.
I want to be in the national title game again.
Never underestimate anybody.
Is it all worth it?
This is crazy.
These are the moments I've worked for. If you want something, you gotta make sacrifice for it.
So why should we hire you?
I'm surprised Deja Fair is still on the clock.
Where do you see?
She's the last person I'm waiting on. Cause I just can't believe she's still on the clock.
Well, the records, they just kept spinning.
Oh, wow.
For Caitlin Clark.
Caitlin Clark. Man, this is... we're not going to do this. Okay? We did it for the national tournament. Don't do this.
Most points in three okay. In a season in D1 history. I mean, how could any human keep up with that? You
I thought
have
you were
going to
try a little bit harder.
I was going to try. A two-time player of the year took her team...
I have no problem with Caitlin Clark, don't get me wrong, but God,
the 2024 WNBA draft, Caitlin Clark joins us now.
Congratulations on being the number one pick, but she got a big target on her back.
When you made this decision, you could have stayed in school another year. You decided to come out, go pro. You obviously couldn't talk at that time about the team that you would likely be going to. But what about the fever and knowing that you likely would be headed to Indiana made it appealing to you?
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is it's an organization that really cares about women's basketball. They want to do a first class. You know, obviously getting to play with Aaliyah that lights your eyes up as a point guard.
Girl,
yeah, I think it's just exciting. They want to get back
hey
to
the
winning ways.
All
obviously,
right,
championship pedigree there, and what Linda has done has been absolutely incredible. So I can't imagine a better place. Obviously, it's the Midwest. Everybody knows it's going to be a hard ticket to get. So if you haven't got your tickets yet, you better get them now. I'm excited.
I'm telling y'all, them tickets finna be 150.
Fan of the WNBA for a long time.
What Tonio said, the nosebleeds finna be 250.
Test your own abilities.
Y'all better go and get them tickets.
Yeah, honestly, and that's a huge reason of why I decided to leave
college. Use game seat. Hold on, I'm show y'all. I'm show y'all the ones I got. Hold on.
You get to a point where it's like, all right, I'm ready for something new. That's exactly
use game time. Hold on, I'm sure y'all. Game time
against the best players in the world.
Or
see
to get y'all tickets.
The competitive leagues.
That's what I use. Or Ticketmaster. But sometimes game time be having the cheapest ticket. As well as see because you can put like discount codes in.
Talk about your passing.
Hold on, let me go and look up the tickets.
What
are
you
for this? We got Aaliyah Edwards. So.
Honestly, I think an easy thing, like as you start your
let's see, because the Washington Mystics first game.
I'm so
game.
Lucky to play with such amazing players and a roster full of a lot of talent.
Is
honestly,
May 14th.
Is one of the best post players in the league, one of the best
matter of fact,
in the world. Like,
I'm going to look up the Indiana Fever. And
you know,
see
Aaliyah's a former
how much they
daily. I thought she had some beautiful words about you at the end of South Carolina.
See how their tickets run right now.
On the podium talking about how you lifted the game of women's basketball this year, something that you'll be tasked with.
The Indiana
well
Fever are playing the Washington Mystics.
And talked about the load you've had
on
to
June 7th. Guess how much the ticket is
unprecedented
right now.
And you're still just trying to go out and do your job.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is
$177.
Like, I am and the player that I've been able to be. And
look at this.
That's exactly how I want to go into the WNBA.
Do y'all see
don't
this?
Change anything that I've done.
Do y'all see these
prices? Find ways to get better.
$286 to sit in the nosebleeds is crazy.
Think about it. That's the
what?
That I wanted. And
$319 to sit in the nosebleeds.
People around me have
I know y'all think I'm lying, but look, seriously.
That's why I got into basketball because
$319.
How lucky am I?
Because they're playing the Indiana Fever. I'm not going to that game.
Well,
are you serious?
Hearing us talk about you to a mega
all night long.
Yeah. Crowd all
I'm
night.
Sorry, guys.
Caitlin, thank you so much.
The cheapest ticket
thank you.
For this game is $211.
Repeat champions in league history. The Houston Comets, of course, winning four straight titles to begin the WNBA era.
All right, I'm finna see.
Back-to-back titles, and it had not
Chicago Sky.
Two decades until the Las Vegas Aces did it a season ago. Just remarkable.
How much those tickets finna be
from the Aces,
when they play the
Mystics? Incredible coaching from
$27.
You know, this is an Aces team. They are
like,
off to
They play, you've seen it now. The Sky play the Mystics on the 6th, the day before Kaylin comes. And the tickets are $27. $27. WNBA championship, and if you look at, but because Kaylin's coming to town,
it's at the point guard position. Man, when I was in touch with Becky Hammond just this past weekend, I said, "Do you think De'Asia Fair might be available at your pick?" And her response is, "I wish." Well, De'Asia Fair is available right now, and if there is a coach who knows how to utilize an undersized guard,
I'm disappointed.
Yeah, if there, that's exactly what I was thinking. If De'Asia Fair could learn from anyone, Becky Hammond would be such a
special. So pick her up, please.
Well, we're gonna find out.
Pick up De'Asia Fair. From Becky Stop Hammond it. Right Cause now. Y'all... The pick is in the first. All right, let's go. Tonight. Please be De'Asia Fair.
The Las Vegas Aces.
With the 16th pick in the 2024 WNBA Draft, the Las Vegas Aces select De'Asia Fair.
There we go. There we go. There we go. Let's go. All right. Go get your ringer. Go get your ringer. Wow.
It was amazing hearing so many of the players who would go up against De'Asia Fair towards the end of the season get to the podium afterwards and talk about how difficult she is to stop, how much respect they have for her game. And now she takes that game to the professional level.
I'm surprised she went this low on the draft. I ain't gonna lie.
She joins the two-time MVP, Asia Wilson. She joins Chelsea Gray and Kelsey Plum and Jackie Young and Candace Parker, who's back as well. Pretty good squad.
The Aces got a nice team, so I just hope that she don't get waived. Because I just hope she don't get waived. Because she's actually a nice player. I don't want her to end up like Alexis Morris, bro. I don't need her getting waived. Because she one of them. She nice.
She is a special talent going to a special team.
But I don't think, because, you know, she 5'5". I don't want them to play on that because she 5'5". You know what I'm saying?
This is a young woman.
But she's nice, though.
That's the only knock on her game is her size. And again,
that's what I'm saying. It's the only thing is there's, like, hinder her is that she 5'5". But she really liked that. Seriously, she really liked that.
Well, De'Asia, everywhere you've gone, well, you level up, your game levels up. You started out scoring 33 points a game in high school, then in college at Buffalo, then at Syracuse, you became the number 3 career scorer in Division I basketball history. How are you, yes, let's take a moment for that.
She wanted him.
How are you able to level up your game no matter
what? Las Vegas might have did they big one with this pick.
It's a mindset. I mean, Coach Jack has instilled a mindset in me since the day we met, so.
Your mindset is big. Becky Hammond was an undrafted, undersized guard. You're being drafted tonight, and I know that your size doesn't bother you at all. You found a way to succeed. How is Becky Hammond seeing something special in you?
I think we kind of played similar. I was nominated for the award, I believe, 3 seasons in a row. So that says a lot.
Yeah, the Becky Hammond Point Guard Award, right? One of the things that always made her special in this league is her movement off the ball and coming back to the ball and getting.
De'Asia Fair on my list for the WNBA. I need her to do her big one.
I think she'll be able to.
Cause she's nice for her.
You know, as being my new head coach, let's do it.
All right, let's do it. Becky Hammond, you got a good one here.
Thank you.
All right, De'Asia Fair.
I'm fine. I'm glad she got picked up. Charisma Osborne still on the top. I mean, on the board, but.
We now have the New York Liberty's second pick of the night with the 17th pick in the 2024 WNBA Draft. The New York Liberty select as Mary Martinez from the University of Arizona.
I don't know who that is.
So the second selection of the evening for the New York Liberty as they take as Mary Martinez.
I have no idea who that is.
And we go right.
Well, congratulations to her, because I'm
the Las Vegas Aces back on the clock and in with their 18th pick.
Dang, who they picking? Dang! Oh, they did have 2 back-to-back picks.
With the 18th pick in the 2024 WNBA Draft, the Las Vegas Aces select Kate Martin, University of Iowa.
Oh, that's another Iowa player. Good job, girl. You a guard too? Congratulations, girl. I'm so proud of you, girl. Congratulations. Oh, for real? They ain't even show her highlights, but I guess they put their picks in back to back like that for real, so.
For Kate Martin, a player considered the glue of these Iowa teams that have captured.
Congratulations, Kate Martin.
The country. We saw Kate.
I did see her some in the tournament. I ain't know she declared for the draft, though. I did not know she declared for the draft.
If you're looking for a player who's going to be great in the
locker room, her name was the glue.
Stars, look no further than Kate Martin.
You better go ahead, girl.
Her junior year, her fourth year at Iowa, did a little bit more on the perimeter. Was their three player this year, asked to bang inside a bit more, always willing to step up to the challenge. What an exciting moment.
So what is Charisma Oswald?
She comes
okay.
To support her teammate Caitlin Clark, ends up getting to the Aces, the reigning champion. She's been the coach on the
floor. I'm telling these Indiana Fever tickets. Do y'all not? I'm finna show y'all again. Look at the price, how the prices run, right? This is game time.
She plays under control.
Look at
this. Great pick.
What an awesome
the Indiana Fever game.
$177.
$20. Like, look at this. How you go from like less than $50 to $177?
I think she's gonna get drafted.
That's crazy.
When you hear your name called right now.
Oh man, a lot of emotions. I'm really happy to be here. I was here to support Caitlin, but you know, I was hoping to hear my name called, and all I wanted was an opportunity, and I got it. So I'm really excited.
That's great.
What you do with an opportunity. This is the world champion Las Vegas Aces. How can you make an impact and try to make that roster?
Yeah, I'm super excited for the opportunity. You know, I have a really good work ethic, but more than anything, I think I'm a very versatile player. I can score at multiple levels and I can guard multiple positions, but I'm really excited to get there, and I know I'm gonna give it all I got.
Tough as bleep. Congratulations. Thank you.
That is amazing, bro. That's crazy, though. I ain't gonna lie. Because a lot of people don't be expecting to get their name called. And for her to just be there to support it and actually get her name called, and it was like, that's an amazing feeling. That's amazing. I love that. I'm gonna have to add you to my list, girl. But listen. Hold on, let me pause this so y'all can hear me.
I can't handle this.
Alright, hold on.
Great handle.
Alright. Let me get... All right, y'all. It's been a live, very emotional day. Very emotional. So I'm about to end the live right here, y'all. Got to, you know, get in the bed. But don't worry, I got the WNBA app on my phone. Okay, and I'm keeping up with this here draft. And I'm about to post on my socials. So, check my Twitter, and yeah, mainly my Twitter, X. I'm about to be on there, and Facebook. I'm about to be posting for the rest of the draft. It's been a wild one, I will say that. But yeah, I'll post my who to watch this season list as well on my social media, so make sure y'all follow all my social medias, you know what I'm saying? I love y'all. I appreciate everybody that's been in here. Like I said, this is the most I've ever had in my chat, so I appreciate y'all so much. Welcome to the family for all of y'all. I'm forever grateful. Y'all just don't know. I love y'all. Y'all be safe, and I'll catch y'all on the next live.